How long should a man or a woman sleep?
See, there's no hard and fast rule for that, actually. I think as you grow old, you don't sleep so much. I personally think that way. I sleep very little myself. In the night, about 3 hours. Daytime, about 1 hour or so. But depends on. It depends. So, for sleeping, there's no hard and fast rule. But whatever time you are born, that's the time you want to sleep. So, some people like to sleep in the morning, all right, let them sleep. And some people want to sleep in the night, let them sleep. Makes no difference. But after coming to Sahaja Yoga, all these conditionings disappear. And then you start behaving in a different manner. There's a transformation. And then maximum time you want to give for your meditation, for knowing about Sahaja Yoga, and you get more time. Actually, we have much more, should have much more time than our ancestors, because we don't have to go to the jungles to get our wood for our fire. We don't have to do all the rest of the things they used to do, poor things, they had to go for hunting. Now we have everything in the house, already made, I mean instant, isn't it? And we have the watch on, also that I am watching the watch. But we have no time. We are the worst, they had much more time than we had. So where are we spending the time? While coming here, I just asked him, what do they make? Because I was seeing all Chinese things, Japanese things, and then I saw lots of Greek, and most of them were Italian things in the market shops. I said, what do the Australians make? He said, they make lager. Where do we spend our time? In the ballroom dancing, or in the lager, or in some way destroying ourselves with drugs or something like that? We have no time. We have time for drugs, all right. Then parties, some formal things which have no meaning at all. It conveys nothing. I have been now in London in a position where I had to shake hands with 600 to 700 people. That only I remember the horrible things that happened to the hand. Otherwise I don't remember even the faces of the people. So there should be a better method of developing a rapport between us, understanding each other in a much more natural way. And then we have time. This is the time to enjoy. But nobody enjoys because we are so time-bound. We are so time-bound. Only time to enjoy we don't have. And that's how whatever you people say about sleeping or waking up and all that, is that your regulation doesn't come from the Divine. If it is from the Divine, you just enjoy. Just enjoy your life. You enjoy yourself. Never feel ill or sick. Now I am 67 and every day I am giving lectures, morning, evening. And the smokes, the people smoke. Women, especially in Australia, I don't know what has gone wrong with them. I try to go with the women so that I'll be saved from smoking. They smoke more than the men in here. I don't know. So I've developed a throat trouble. I hope it will be all right. But this is what happens. Where do we spend our time? There then you are beyond time, into the timeless dimension, enjoying yourself. That's the beauty we have to achieve, that state we have to reach. All right?
There's one question from last night.
What is it?
It says, my revered father has been for the past 3 or 4 years experiencing astral sounds, but physically his hearing is impaired, or cut off for all practical purposes. 24 hours a day he is able to tune into the chanting of sacred Hindu hymns, devotional music rendered by an enchanting voice accompanied by a violin, etc. He has done no special tapas or meditation, but he is very naive and a simple soul. Is it because of the awakening of the Kundalini?
No, not at all. Not at all. All these things should not happen to you. don't hear anything, you don't see anything, you become. Just become. This is a subject which has to be dealt with clearly, about the dead souls and things, it's quite a big subject. But if you come to Sahaja Yoga, you'll understand what happens, how you hear these things and how astral things happen, how your caught deaths take place. All these are all negative things and are achieved by people who deal in the science of the dead. So it's very important that you should get out of all these ideas and become yourself. Only way to know if a person is realized is not the way he can handle the kundalini, the way he can feel the vibrations, and the way he leads his own life. When you go to any guru, first of all see the disciples, how they are, how they behave, what powers they have got. Then you accept. That's the sign of a Sadguru. Nanaka has said clearly, Guru Nanak was such an enlightened soul. And he said that the one who meets you, meet God, is the Sadguru. Everybody is not a guru. So should we now have the realization?